people, the Ford Fiesta is a car that needs no introduction. We all know what exactly it is. It's just everything, and it does everything well. It can be a van, it can be a rally car, it can be, you know, a small super mini for families, and it just does everything so well. So what is the secret behind all this? You know, what has Ford done to really make this car so good? Well, for one, they've styled it really nicely. It's using the kinetic design, I believe it's called, and it just looks really, really sharp. So they've done that well. The interior, is it exactly how you'd predict it to be? You know, it's very Germany, you know, everything has a sense where it's supposed to be. You know, every button does exactly what you want it to do. And it's just all around this interior, while it's not very premium looking, it is certainly more premium-ish than those in Skodas, and it's definitely, you know, very well practical. So the interior I like too, this big knobs here for heating controls, everything is again same roundabout, same troubles. So it's the same sort of, you know, what's he looking at? Can I go? Can I go? Yes. Thank you. What are you doing, man? There we go. So what they've done is just made this interior really, really nice. And we haven't come to the Fiesta's best thing of them all. It's how it drives. Because every little detail about, you know, its drivetrain and the engine and the gearbox, everything is just so well done. You know, I'm going to go on my twisty road, and it's just a joy, just how it turns in, and how the steering wheel is shaped. Everything about driving it is just perfect, really. And I have a 1.25 liter engine in this, which is like 80 horsepower. But unlike that in the 208 they reviewed recently, this isn't that modern. This has four cylinders, and it was first designed back in 1995 as a Sigma engine, so it is what Hyundai call proven. And it's really nice. I'm doing 60 in fourth. It's telling me to shift that feet, but just press the accelerator and this thing flies off. And then we come to a corner. Have to use the steering and the brakes and the shifter. Okay, brakes, they give it nicely, they have a nice feel. Turn the steering wheel and it just goes exactly where I want it to. Good feel. And then after the corner, acceleration is, yeah, it's okay, you know. But this excels more in the cornering side of things, not acceleration. Of course, Ford does offer the Fiesta now in a ST version, which is, to some, the best small hot hatchback. You know, mainly because the Fiesta is such a good base for, you know, cars to drive fast. But I'm doing 70 right now, and I'm not even, you know, not even feeling challenged. It just drives so nicely. Of course, the Fiesta does lack a bit in practicality. So the facelifted one actually has a smaller boot than the one before facelift, which is a bit odd, because normally they improve on things. But the only thing David Ford has improved with the facelift is giving it an even better engine lineup, featuring the excellent EcoBoost engine. So, you know, I really can see where Ford is going. It's, why am I using the indicator? Just, yeah. So Ford just takes a car, makes it well to drive, and then let's do anything extra, you know. Let's put an interior on it. It's just so, you can feel that Ford is just putting so many thoughts into how this car drives. corner, approaching corner. There is loads of grip. Of course, this car has 195 tires on it, and you can feel that. You know, so going around this corner, these S turns, going left and going right, and just the car feels happy doing this thing. You know, it's not. Some cars feel like a a corner. No, I must do something with the steering. But this guy just like, yes, drum around the corner. Come on, you know, show me what you can do. It's quite just so quick and easy. It just rewards you for going fast round corners, and you know, or you can go economically too, you know, if you want to be boring. Just slow, easy. And I didn't even need to change gears. I'm all the way in fourth. Normally I'm fourth. Get it? Oh, no, not a good joke. Normally I need to change, you know, third, fourth, all the way. But I can carry so much speed through the corners with this chassis that it's just superb. You never need to change gears on this road. It's only going to fifth, but I'm not. Just braking, slight braking. Yes, this is good. You know. So, I think this really is what this car is. Just a driver's car, and then everything else just is an afterthought, really. You know, if I was like, make this car perfect to drive, and then we'll just style it. Yep, it has some styling on it, which happens to be good. You know, it has this interior, which happens to be good. You know, it's not as practical as some other cars, but what can I say? Just so good to drive that I really can forgive it. Small niggles, you know. Like having a bit small boot, you know. Things like that. Because when you drive it, it feels superb. This gearbox so well sorted, so brakes, feeling perfect. Everything on it perfect. You know, you can see why this car has won so many, you know, 5-star awards in Auto Express, Watt Car, all of those things. And if you haven't driven it, go give it a try, because this is just so good. And go drive it through some corners. Not on the motorway, because that's just putting the fifth, and that's really where this engine would struggle. But roads like this engine has no problems at all. You know, you have to work the gearbox a bit. But turn on the wipers. Happens when you drive fast. You know, a cyclist driving on his own side of the road. Acceleration. Just. Yes. I think I've said enough good things about this car, and I cannot really find a bad one. I'm just looking for one, just be like, aha, that's terrible, but you know, the trip computer is in the right place, the gearbox is good, the driving is good, the steering is good, the styling, the interior, exterior, whatever, just repeating things, but you know, to really think how good this is, you know. Everything is perfect. So, yep. Over the bumps. Yep. It could be more comfortable. Give it that, but it's fine. Really. Acceleration. Yes, not its bright side of this 1.25 liter engine. what can I do? So, yeah, enough of this, and I'll see all of you guys next time in a car which probably wouldn't be as good as this, so, I think. Yeah, goodbye!